I'm talking the weight of your exes. I'm talking the weight of that bad haircut you got. I am talking when you chose, Paige, to wear those wind pants in seventh grade, which I will never get over for like a full year. I am talking all of those bad decisions. Like a magnet to your lips. That's how sticky this is. It is sticky enough to go back decades and talk about all the bad shit you ever done. You don't want that in your life. I don't even want this on my hand. I need to get it off right now. And hello, beautiful people. Welcome back. So for today's video, we're going to be starting this week off hot. And we are talking about 9 or 10-ish products, whatever I have in front of me here. Makeup that I just don't like. Makeup that, for whatever reason, it just does not work for me. These are items that I have tried. I've tried them multiple times. And they are all on like the newer-ish side of release. So I really just want to take a second, share them with you. We're going to talk about it. And I'm going to just share my full experience. You know, if there is an applicable video, which I think for most of them there is, I will, of course, link that video for you so you can see the products in action. But for today, I really just wanted to sit down and focus on, you know, these few products, what I like, what I don't like, you know, if they have good qualities, bad qualities, all the in between, and just deliver that to you and hopefully do this in a constructive way, because you guys know that when I get going, I can become a little overzealous and I can become a little bit more shady than I would like. So I'm just gonna, like, you know, sit here, talk about it, and we'll see how it goes. Let's go ahead and just get today's video started. I'm just gonna dive in with one product that, like, it really truly it upsets me on like a spiritual level, I feel. And I think it's just because, like, I tried to make it work so many times and I couldn't make it work ever. So let's just, you know, we're gonna start off on the drugstore. I promise I do have some higher end items here as well, so their time is coming, believe me. I don't spare anybody. But let's go ahead and start in the drugstore with this Milani cream to powder foundation. This is something I used this for the first time in my full face of new makeup or whatever from Milani. I'll link it up here. And I was so excited and so optimistic about this foundation, guys, because the texture of this foundation, it feels so good. Like, it has such a beautiful, rich, creamy, like, oh my God, the texture of this is so satisfying when you swatch through it. It has just such a velvety, smooth feel. And then as you go through and you kind of buff it into the skin, like obviously right now I'm buffing it into my hand, it just buffs in so nice and, like, kind of has an even texture over top of it. And then you can start to feel that kind of powderiness come through as it dries down. And it really does go from a cream type consistency to a powder. And believe me when I tell you guys, when I first tried this and I felt this consistency, I expected this, like, this beautiful, velvety, like, oh yes, honey, cream to powder moment. That's what I expected on my face. Is that what I got on my face? Absolutely not. I ended up getting, oh honey, let me just set that down because I need both hands. I'm one of those people. I couldn't talk if you tied my arms behind my back. Like, that's me. And you guys know this. You've seen me before. It's a whole situation. But this foundation made me so upset because as I applied it and I tried it, like, in that video, I think I tried brush and a sponge or just a sponge. I'm not really sure. But after that video was over, I have tried this foundation so many times. Brushes and sponges, mixing them together, trying like a concealer base, mixing it with other foundations, like trying any way that I can possibly think of to make this foundation look as good on my face as it does on the back of my hand. And then it occurred to me, do you know what the back of my hand doesn't have that my face has? Oh, I have a list. Wrinkles, pores, texture, acne, all kinds of scarring. And none of those are, again, present on the back of my hand. And it was in that moment that I realized this foundation will only look good on a surface that is basically already baby ass smooth. And I got news for you. That ain't my 30-year-old face, okay? I got all kinds of crevasses and pores and situations that need to be dealt with and, like, really loved and cared for on a daily basis. This foundation settles into every single crack, every pore, crevasse, wrinkle, texture. It settles into any discrepancy in an otherwise smooth surface. I just don't need a foundation or really anything to remind me that, like, I'm 30 years old and I got a bunch of wrinkles on my face. Like, I got that under wraps. I'm well aware that they're there. And for me, this product is just one that, like, let me just, like, slide it away. It makes me, oh, it gets me. It, guys, that foundation made me so mad on many a morning. So I'm done. I'm done messing with it. Let's move on. Actually, I lied. The next product I have for you is also from Milani. So why don't we just stay on that boat for one second? I want to say I picked this up maybe like 3-ish months ago, back before the Rona, you know, when we could just, like, do crazy things, like go to Walgreens and walk around and, like, shop just for fun. Crazy times. I know, it's so weird to, like, think back that far. But this is a product that I picked up and it got me so good. So imagine a day I walk into Walgreens. It's like, I want to say maybe a Saturday, something like that. I'm just out and about, you know, living my life, doing some errands. And I'm like, like, oh, I need to stop in at Walgreens. Why? I have no idea, but I felt like I needed to stop in there. And while I was in there, I was like, hey, I need to get a lip balm. And I was over by the cosmetics. I look up and I see this. This is the Milani Green Goddess Transforming Lip Balm. And I was like, oh my God, I really wanted to test out this line. This is so exciting. They had one left on the shelf. So I grab it. Yes. I get out to my car, right? And I just like slather it on, honey. Cause like I've told you in other videos, man, when I'm putting on a lip balm, I'm just like, okay, I get in there with my lip balm and I'm not wearing any makeup. So like, who cares? You know, I just, it doesn't matter if I get like a little extra, that good old balmy, greasy situation, like around the perimeter, it doesn't matter. So I apply it and I sit there for a second, put the lid on, put my seatbelt on. I go to back up. And like most people, or hopefully like most people, I check behind me to make sure I check my mirrors. And as I check up here to like look in my rearview mirror, I catch a glimpse of my lips, and you can imagine my surprise when my lips are no longer my normal little face lips. Oh no, they have been replaced with this hot pink situation on my hand. And I know it doesn't look like much, okay, but I want you to imagine this pink, this bright ass, I'm a Barbie doll pink. I want you to imagine that, not just on my lips, which are already a bright type shade of pink and red on their own, okay? My lips are naturally fairly pigmented. But I want you to add to that then the realization that what did I just say I do with my lip balm, right? I really just get in there, honey, and I get it all over the place. So now it looks like I have this color all around my mouth, honey. I just ate 17 popsicles. I smeared them all over. I was basically finger painting myself with popsicle juice, slushy juice, and every other type of red pigment you can imagine. And I looked like a damn fool, all right? And I'm well aware that that's not the lip balm's fault, okay? The consistency of this is great. I have no issues with it. Like, as far as a product, like the quality of it, it seems really nice. And I have been trying to get use out of this, you know, putting it on a little bit, like maybe before a liquid lipstick or a pencil or something like that, just to give my lips a little bit of hydration, and then I quickly cover it up. And I just want to throw out there, I know it's not Milani's fault. Milani, if you guys are watching this, it is not your fault that I put my lip balm on all the way up to my damn eyebrows, okay? That is not on you. That is on me. However, it just kind of reiterates the feeling that I have about transforming products in general, which is why it's in this video. Like, I just... I hate products that transform. I don't care if it's a lipstick, a lip balm, a blush, whatever. I don't like it. I feel like they look so horrible on me. All right, beautiful people. So now the door is closed. I was off camera here for about 10-ish minutes or so because my parents got home, and my dog's new favorite thing to do, if they are home and I'm back here, I can't have the door open because she will just run her happy little 60, 70 pound ass up and down that hallway. Room, room, room. And it's just her favorite thing in the world to do because she wants me to go sit out there, and she doesn't understand why, like, I'm back here, you know, doing my own thing. So I have to shut the door, which is like heartbreaking for her because she doesn't understand why she doesn't have full 100% access to me at all times, which those of you with dogs or cats will totally understand. Like, your animal, does your animal not just get like so pissed off at you if you shut the door? Like, I'm not trying to be rude. I'm just trying to film. And let's face it, your little clickety click toenails up and down the hallway, honey, that is just not it for me. Okay. I don't need that. I don't need that distraction in my life. I get distracted by everything. If a fuzzle flies through the air, I'm like, ooh, I'm already distracted enough, okay? And it's just, it is amazing to me how upset my dog gets when I shut this door. All of that has really nothing to do with anything other than to tell you, hey guys, I'm back, the door is now shut, and I'm ready to get on with the next product. So that was a whole lot of explanation for absolutely nothing. And now we're gonna talk about another product that I absolutely hate, and that is this guy from Makeup Revolution. This is the Makeup Revolution Glass Lip Gloss, and this was a part of their Glass Skin Collection, which I did a full review on this entire collection from them, I want to say maybe mid-March, so a couple of months ago. I will, of course, link it up there for you if you'd like to see it. But this lip gloss, you guys, oh my God. First of all, I want to start this off by saying there are very few things in the makeup world I love as much as a lip gloss. Like, lip glosses for me are, they're my kryptonite, okay? If you come out with a collection of lip glosses, I want them all. I don't care that they are barely different from each other. I want every single one because that's just like who I am in my heart and soul. I love lip glosses. And this right here, not only is it a lip gloss, but it is also a clear lip gloss. And I know some people think clear lip glosses are just so stupid. I think, however, unpopular, maybe popular opinion, I don't know, but I think that clear lip gloss is like the universal item of makeup that you can literally wear at any time of any sort of makeup stage. It can be a no makeup makeup day, clear lip gloss, and it looks beautiful. Your lips look juicy and pouty and wonderful. On a super glam full day, little clear lip gloss, it looks beautiful, wonderful. Any nude you're wearing, if you're wearing a bright color, it does not matter what you're wearing, full glam, anything in between, a clear lip gloss can just look so beautiful. unless it is this clear lip gloss. Guys, this is the worst clear lip gloss, okay? It excels at only one thing. Being clear. That is the only thing that this is good at. Everything else, the longevity, the texture, the way that the way that this sits on your lips. Okay, let me just tell you, this has, oh my God, just look at it. As I apply it, like the little wand just like sticks to my hand. Oh, the texture of this lip gloss is horrible. And then just to be fair, here is the swatch. You can see it has like a really beautiful reflection. It is super shiny. And again, I show you these things because I like to be fair, right? If it's beautiful, I'm gonna show you it's beautiful. But unfortunately, you know, despite its beautiful appearance, this is the thickest, the stickiest, and the most unappealing texture. Like you can sit down and I want you to like picture the most undesirable texture for a gloss, and this is like 10 times worse than that texture. It is so unbelievably, if when I put this on my mouth, let me say it this way, all right? I put this on my lips and I literally, my lips stuck together, okay? That is how sticky this is. Like, I know you can't see it on camera because there's no way to like properly convey this, but the stickiness of this on your lips, it is so, it feels like I put on like 13 layers of a thick, non-drying liquid lipstick and then put a layer of like Elmer's glue on top. That is what it feels like to wear this gloss. It's absolutely horrible. If you want to try it and you know, you think it's beautiful, whatever, I can't blame you. Try it at your own risk. But I'm here to tell you right now, honey, you wear this out. This is sticky enough. Everything you've ever done, all your bad decisions are going to be sticking to your lips. That is how sticky and tacky this is. I'm talking the weight of your exes. I'm talking the weight of that bad haircut you got. I am talking when you chose, Paige, to wear those wind pants in seventh grade, which I will never get over for like a full year. I am talking all of those bad decisions, like a magnet to your lips. That's how sticky this is. It is sticky enough to go back decades and talk about all the bad shit you ever done. You don't want that in your life. I don't even want this on my hand. I need to get it off right now. But look at what I do have. This is the Fenty Gloss in Glass Slipper. This is a clear gloss. Oh yeah, look at that. Oh my God. I just saw it sitting here and I was like, you know, while we're on the topic, so glossy, so juicy, so satisfying, such a good formula. Not sticky. Look at that. Not sticky at all. Yes. Guys, I need to ask you a very honest question. Did I have a little piece of lipstick on my teeth this entire time and nobody told me, or just recently? Because I just looked in here to put that lip gloss on and I had lip gloss on my main tooth. On my main tooth right up front. Ain't nobody gonna tell me. Okay. Rude. Okay, so I know that I said we were gonna be like picking up the pace and that last one was like 7 hours worth of talking, but I promise I'm actually gonna go quicker. And so the next item I have here, this is from Glow Recipe. So this kind of like hurts my heart and soul. I think I got this in a BoxyCharm. This is their Watermelon Glow Ultra Fine Mist for hydrating and glowy radiance. And this spray, I wanted to love it so bad. I don't even know where the lid is. Like, this thing looks so weird to hold up on camera. It's like, what the hell is that thing? But anyways, the long and short of this setting spray, I don't need to like waste a ton of time on it. I just don't feel like this does anything for my skin. And every time that I wear it, I feel like it actually emphasizes my texture. And I think if like boiling it down, I think what it is that there are those like fine, tiny little particles of like glitter or shimmer or something in here. And I think that as I spray that onto my skin, for some reason, those tiny little particles like stick to my texture. And I don't know if it's just the formulation or maybe a ratio of that shimmery type quality to the actual spray itself. I can't figure out what it is about this product that like doesn't work on my skin, because I feel like this has worked for so many other people and people all across the aisle, combo skin, dry skin, whatever. They have all really enjoyed this product. And for me, I just feel like when I apply it, it just looks like straight up shimmer on my face. And I wish that I could understand, because look at that. It's not even the spray. Like, can you see? It actually has a beautiful spray. It's a nice light mist. So theoretically speaking, there should be no reason that I don't like this. You know, it has all of the properties that I look for in a spray, but for some reason, my skin just does not like this. Does that mean that I won't still try to get use out of it? Absolutely not. Like, I'll still try to maybe layer it in. You guys know I layer like 6 setting sprays in one day. All right, so this next product, I think I can save a whole lot of time on, catch us up a little, and get into this one about 30 seconds or less. So we have from Essence, these are the Glow My Mind Crystal Sponge Sets. And I just use these in What's New with Essence, I wanna say. I'll link it up here. It's a fairly recent video. And guys, this sponge set, just in case you see it and you're like me and you're a sponge lover, you love testing out new profiles, whatever, this is so stupid, okay? Do not test this. And I know most of you are like, well, yeah, Paige, we wouldn't be dumb enough to try that. I can't help myself, okay? It's just a sponge. I love testing things. And who knows? Maybe it could have been good. But it wasn't. It was absolutely horrible, and you don't need them. Not only is the profile of this sponge absolutely ridiculous, again, it's the profile of a diamond, and there's nothing advantageous about the cut of this at all. I find the shape of it to be useless and a little bit more difficult to like hold and blend, personal opinion. But in addition to that, the actual sponge itself is horrible. It's not a good quality sponge. So when you go in and try to use this to blend out or press anything into your skin, the sponge just attracts all the product off of your face and into the sponge. So it ends up costing you a lot of time, a lot of money in product, and you don't need this. This is absolute hot fire garbage, and you don't need it. Essence has some great stuff, but oh my God, this set, don't. Oh my God, don't. You heard me, don't. Also, no one was gonna tell me that my necklace was like upside down, backwards, the little clasp was showing. Nobody wants to tell me nothing? Okay, it's fine. I'm judging you. Now, I do have one more item from Essence. Again, not picking on them because they're affordable, drugstore, whatever. There was a ton of good stuff in that video. But this item, if you watch the video, you probably know what it is. It makes me... Ooh, it makes me a little bit upset, a little bit opinionated, and that would be their All Eyes on Me Multi-Effect Mascara. Honey, there is no multi-effect about this mascara. It gives you one effect, nothing, okay? It is the most bland, useless. I mean, let me put it this way. I think I got the same effect from this mascara as if I took like a black paint, like if I was painting with watercolor, and I just thought, my God, this black watercolor looks nice and watered down. Why don't I take and like brush that onto my lashes? It was literally the same effect as this mascara. This gives you absolutely nothing. There is no body, no lengthening, no color, like absolutely nothing to my lashes. And it was work for me to get any, even the black color of mascara, to get that color to stick to my lashes was next to impossible. And there's just, it doesn't give you anything. Like, I have tried this, and I even tried it 3 more times after that video, because again, you know, before I do these, I like to really test stuff out. And every single time I use this, I get so irritated. And I just want to put that out there, because I know we're always on the hunt for like the new and the cheapest, and mascara is one of those things that there are a ton of more budget friendly options, but this just is not one of them. Like, if you were considering it because it says multi-effect, or because it says on the bottle here that this gives extra volume, girl, wear. It says length, curl, thickness, and separation. Literally not one of those things did it do for me. So this is a huge pass. No, no, no. All right, so next up we have something from Catrice, which you guys know Catrice is one of my favorite drugstore brands. But unfortunately, this product, which I tested about 2 months ago in a what's new at the drugstore, I want to say, of course, I'll link it up here. This just did not do it for me. This is the Catrice HD Baking and Setting Loose Powder. It says that it is mattifying, water resistant, and gives you a second skin effect. And I... dare I say, I could not hate this product more if I tried. Let me just show you, okay? In the container, it doesn't look that bad. It has like a nice little netting system. The component, everything about it is really good. But the actual product itself doesn't seem that dark. Here it is swatched on my finger. Again, doesn't seem that dark. For some reason, when I apply this, and I know obviously you can't see me swatch it on my hand, but when I apply this to my under eye, it gives me the most like unnatural, almost sick looking under eyes, because it's so shadowed, and that's the only way I can think to describe it. No matter what I do, I cannot get rid of it. Like, again, I've tried different ways of applying, I've tried different, you know, preps and concealers and all kinds of stuff, and at the end of the day, for some reason, this powder just will not work on me. Okay, so the last two products I have are both from Fenty, and this, I know it's probably shocking you, it's shocking me, it's shocking everyone, because I love Fenty, okay? Like, it's probably one of those brands that, especially lately, I have gravitated towards more than almost any other brand. Hell, I think right now I'm probably wearing 6 things from Fenty, that, which by the way, everything will be linked down below, but like, I'm wearing the eyeshadow palette, I'm wearing the new cream bronzer, I just added the gloss, I'm wearing the liner, I use the spray. Like, I use so many things from Fenty on a day-to-day basis lately, it's actually alarming. So all that being said, the first product that I have to talk about from them is one that I know a lot of other people are really enjoying, and that would be none other than their new Full Frontal Mascara. And guys, I tried to love this. I really, really did. And it does have its redeeming points, which we'll get to in a second, but ultimately, this mascara for me, it just doesn't do enough. Like, it doesn't give me enough of what I'm looking for in a mascara. Now, again, a couple of caveats. Let's go ahead and talk about it. Let's not hate me just yet, okay? For me, because I don't wear false lashes and I don't really go in and do like anything crazy with my lashes, I need a mascara that will really go in and it builds me volume and it gives me length and definition and bulk, and just, I need it to give me everything all at once. And it, you know, it is asking a lot for a mascara. What I get from this Fenty one is more of like a one and done. It gives me more individual type lashes, but it doesn't give me anything, and I mean anything, in the way of building up my volume, in the way of building up my length, or giving me any sort of just like oomph that I can really work with. I think it all boils down to the formula with this mascara. It's a lot thinner, it's not super thick. Ergo, for me, it's not very voluminous. It doesn't just give me like that, ooh, that really abrupt texture that I like. So again, I don't think that it's absolutely awful. For me, it is more of a fail because it's not the mascara type that I like. But you know, just me to you, if you have it, you're struggling in the same way. I think that as a lower lash line mascara, it looks good. The last item that I have for you is actually this little guy. This is the Glow Skin Stick in the shade Pearl, and it is from the Matchstick line. And I think if I had to describe this, I would say that this is more of, there's like a big old swatch of it right there. It has a nice light luminescent to it. It just has like a really light sheen. But my biggest issue with this is actually twofold. Part one, I don't like the fact that this is marketed as something you can use under foundation and over foundation, because over foundation, at least what I found, is that this does have more of an oily type consistency to it, which I know you can't really convey on camera, but it has like an oil slick kind of feel to it, right? And that feeling when you go in, and I don't care how you apply it, like if you apply it like this over foundation, even taking a sponge and like trying to do it like, you know, just placing it over top of your foundation. No matter how I try to apply it, because it has that oily type feel, it just removes, like I'm talking instantly removes any and all foundation or whatever product that I have on like the high points of my face. And so I have been completely unable to use that over anything on my face because it just removes it. Again, because of the consistencies. Then I tried to use it under and, you know, blend over top like I normally would. And again, I still had an issue with that oily type texture because my foundation, like nothing would stick in that area because it has more of that oily type feel. It just repelled all of my other products. And so not only could I not use it over top of my foundation, but I really couldn't use it under my foundation either because it just repels everything. But that being said, it just, as you know, playing the devil's advocate, I did try this on a day where I wanted like a no makeup makeup look. And so I went in, I had just very, very light, a little bit of brow, a little bit of mascara, and I think maybe like a spot conceal with just like my YSL spot concealing concealer. And I put just the tiniest amount, because other than those three things, there was nothing else on my face. So I took a tiny amount of this on just my bare skin, and I lightly dabbed it on like the high points right through here, a little bit on the nose, the chin, that sort of thing. And it did look really beautiful, just like settling into my skin. And it almost behaved like a shimmery kind of like serum oil. Like it just settled in and it gave me a nice natural luminescent. It worked okay, you know, as long as, again, it was by itself and it was just a no makeup makeup day sort of thing. So for me, that's kind of where that product lands. It's just, it's a fail for me because it's not how I would use a product like that. You know, if I'm gonna buy something like this that's 25, 30, whatever, however much this thing costs, if I'm gonna buy something like this, which I did purchase this, none of it was sent to me, I want to be able to get more use out of this than just like no makeup makeup day, light little oomph. And maybe if I'm being honest, it's just a me situation, because when I bought this, I kind of thought it would be something a little bit more like this. This is the ColourPop highlight stick. This is in the shade Starbright, and I actually have a swatch right here. It's just a beautiful glowy cream type highlight, and I can apply it over my foundation. It works beautiful. Like, this is probably one of my favorite products that ColourPop makes in general, and it's all about that consistency. So maybe it's just a me thing, and I thought the consistency of this, instead of being more on the oily side, maybe it's because I thought it would be more of an actual cream type matchstick, which a lot of their other formulas have been. Again, that's just me. It could be personal preference, I'm not sure. But you guys, that's the end of the video, so you can let me know your thoughts down below, whether it is on this matchstick or anything else I've talked about. Did you try it? Did you like it? Thoughts, opinions on any of this or any makeup that you have tried that you don't like? Leave all of that down below. Also, just above those comments, if you scooch up to the description box, you will find my Instagram and my Twitter, which will be linked in there along with all of the makeup if you're wanting to see what I'm wearing for today's video. Of course, if you haven't subscribed yet, please be sure to do that before you leave. I put up 3 new videos a week, Monday, Wednesday, Friday, and they go up around 7 a.m. my time here in good old Northern Michigan. So subscribe, turn on your post notifications, and you guys, that is it. Thank you all so much for watching. Please don't forget to have a great day, night, weekend, whatever it is when you're watching this, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.
Is anybody else like a little concerned why my head is a square? Like, does it, no, just me? Okay.
Well, hello, beautiful.
My eyes were shut.
Welcome to Monday. If you are watching this today,
that was aggressive.
Picture it, Michigan, roughly 3 months ago, pre-quarantine.